This is Skyrim commentary from Shonner Films.
Meanwhile, in Markarth, some severe thunder and lightning showing up in my neighborhood. Apparently, it's gonna rain out in the desert here. Flash flood warnings, that kind of thing.
Excuse me, do you know anything about this house? Seen anyone enter or leave?
This guy always creeps me out. He just shows
like
up out of nowhere.
The city has amnesia.
He blends in with that wall too much.
Only the natives and the Nord stay in Markarth now.
As they always have, along with those crazed Forsworn. Driven off the color that used to make the city great.
I need to get back to the customers. We'll talk more of this when I come home tonight.
I'm just walking around.
Like my father, and his father before him.
Looking at NPCs.
Papa says I'm too friendly with strangers. But you seem all right.
Making sure NPCs haven't died off yet. Because this place, I don't know why, but NPCs will spawn on the edge of a walkway and fall to their death. I also wanted to see if I could break this guy by coming in here before I'm supposed to. So he's just standing there.
I'm sorry to drag you into Markarth's problems, but after that attack in the Mark... You're an outsider. You're dangerous looking.
You want answers? Well, so do I. So does everyone in the city. A man goes crazy in the market. Everyone knows he's a Forsworn agent. Guards do nothing.
Oh, yeah, so he continues on as if I read his note.
This has been going on for years, and all I've been able to find is murder and blood. I need help. Please, you find out why that woman was attacked.
I hope I can get this
who's behind Wayland and the Forsworn.
Commentary done before the power goes out around here.
She's not from Markarth. The air about her screamed outsider. Visitors to the city usually stay at the Silverblood Inn. Be careful who you talk to.
I was curious if any guards come after me, but I don't think I've done enough for the guards to start pestering me about stuff. I have to be, I think, two clues in before the guards start warning me about things.
You want to give up now? Out of fear?
The most
is that what we're going to teach our daughter?
I've ever seen. Guards should take you away.
The only people I offend are teachers who don't
came. What'd she say? The guards should take you away.
Good meat when I throw it at her faces.
If you ever think of throwing meat at me, I will have you dragged off to Sidna Mine so fast the guards will yank those filthy arms of yours off.
Got to keep my eyes open. Damn dragons could swoop down at any time.
Give people good food at good prices, and all they do is insult you.
She's trying to get him canceled. So last night when I was
the Silverblood Inn has plenty of strong drink
playing this game. Oh, there's a dead person, yeah. There's a lot of dead people in my taverns. I must be falling asleep while I'm playing the game, because I'll come back the next day and I'll start the game in a tavern. There's a dead body laying there, all stripped naked. I'm like, who? I don't remember this person dying in my game. That piece of gold was stuck in the plate. I couldn't get it. I couldn't move the plate. I couldn't get the gold. This door was already open, right? I just helped myself. Aha. Now a guard should come after me, right? There's a dead person there too. I vaguely remember that. I think it was a vampire that died. These vampires are starting to show up in my game. So stuff is dying. I should say games. Both my legendary and my special edition versions of Skyrim. Vampires are on the loose. See? Someone just fell. Oh, he looks okay. He didn't fall too hard. He only fell from the bridge. So I was looking up sci-fi role-playing games, tabletop, and I found one called Those.
I've seen you snooping around, asking questions. Back off. You don't want to know what happens to troublemakers here. Funny. This is your last warning, outsider. We keep the peace here. Stay out of our business.
So, about a year ago, a game came out called Those Dark Places. It's based on industrial style sci-fi, like Outland, Alien, Blade Runner, you know, 70s gritty sci-fi dystopian style. And I did the review, you know, the sneak preview of the game to, you know, read what it's like. And I got to some of the rules part of it. So I'm a huge Traveler fan, Mongoose Traveler, second edition. And I'm always comparing sci-fi games with that. Because Mongoose Traveler 2nd Edition is the gold standard when it comes to sci-fi role-playing. Oh, now it's raining. Finally, the clouds burst. And, so once in a while, I find a game on the internet that does sci-fi. And I'll look at the rules and I want to say Mothership was one that I looked at a year ago, 2 years ago, and I didn't much care for that one. And this one called Those Dark Places, it's written by Jonathan Hicks. The rules are written for, like, I want to say 4th graders, 5th graders? Not teenagers. So Traveler is written for teenagers. Teenagers and up. And when rules are written for a kid, I don't like that. I don't understand why games are being written for kids. It's like comic books. Comic books are written for grown-ups. Kids could read them. Kids could learn from the comics, learn to read from the comics, because the characters in the books use big words. And comics would kind of cover adult themes sometimes. But you don't want to dumb down a comic book. You never want to do that. And you don't want to dumb down a role-playing game. But I don't know why the authors are insisting on doing this now. Apparently Dungeons & Dragons was too gory, too adult-like for kids. So they got to come out with the dumbed-down version of these games for kids. It's like, in today's modern age, we live in a society where we have to, treat kids worse than dogs, you know? Dogs and cats get treated better than kids do. Kids are down there with goldfish as far as how they're treated. You know, they have to be coddled. They have to have the helicopter mom flying around. They have to have the, they can't go outside. They'll get hurt. Don't play on the fence or the tree, the jungle gym. Don't play on that. You'll get hurt. Don't play sports. You'll get hurt. Don't ride a bike. Oh, you'll... All these things. Kids stay indoors and they're like playing on the phone. That's what the kids would do now, is they play on the phone. And you know what phones are for, right? The whole purpose of a phone is to be two clicks away from boobs. That's the whole point of a phone. So yeah, let's give those to kids. So no wonder kids grow up acting like Nexus 6. You know, they have no emotional...
What do you want him
here? They have no coping skills. Kids have no coping skills. And then they grow up to adults with no coping skills. All because they played a role-playing game that was written for a child. And they're... I don't know. Apparently I was ranting just now. What are we doing here?
Mm-hmm.
I want to talk to the Jarl about
bless you.
The Skooma. The Skooma that's happening in Riften.
Oh, thank you.
It's a plague that must
Divines
be rid of.
Bless your kind
buying and selling fine jewelry.
The fairest prices and the highest quality.
Genuine blood elixir for sale. Lived for thousands of years. See into other people's thoughts.
What am I looking at? It looks like my head is looking down at something. Like... something died in the river.
I hope the wilds claim you one of these days.
What? Is it because I...
Good journey, my child.
I deal with Daedra. Is she pissed off about that? What about this person? I've already been in this room.
What do you need, my friend? I felt a caress on my cheek. We've made peace with... I thank you.
Here, yeah.
Please accept this as a token of my appreciation.
I thought I got rid of that body. The body was on the ground. Stripped and everything. And now it's all neatly being prepared on the table. I took its clothes for some reason. I think I installed the mod that had new underwear, and I wanted to try them on.
Gems, potions, exotic...
Yes, it's what you think. I wanted to try on women's underwear. No, actually... When you grab female clothing and you're a dude, the dude the clothing instantly changes to the dude style. If you're a girl and you grab guy's clothes... off his
it's
back,
so good to see you again.
It immediately turns into a dress that you can wear.
I don't know why I bother.
And there's mods out there now where if you're a guy and you steal a dress and you put
Take
it on,
my advice. Stay at the
it's
D&R.
Still a dress.
The bunkhouse isn't for you.
You're a dude in a dress. Congratulations. And if you're a girl and you grab a guy's outfit and you put it on, well, guess what? You're wearing a guy's outfit. Technically, I like the idea of women wearing guys' outfits, like if it's armor. I don't know if that's historically accurate. I mean, women wearing guys' armor. We know they didn't have boob armor, right? They had something. And we all know that guys wearing girl armor is gay. And but for some reason it seems to be catching on in today's society.
An amulet of Mara. You're looking for marriage then?
What did you want? Be seeing you around.
Anyway, so I was looking at those kinds of mods. And they require so much patches, it wasn't worth it. It wasn't worth it. I don't want to patch my game further. I want to keep it simple, stupid. Oop, I saw some lightning. That means the thunder is...
What was
that lightning's far away. Took forever for the thunder. Is that... That lightning is a good 10 miles away. I don't have to worry about my computer being zapped. Well, that was the fastest battle ever in this area. Usually someone takes a knee or something, or I get bashed down. I get bashed and I'm yielding or whatever, or I have to heal myself to get back up and rejoin the fight. But usually the fight is right here, right by the front door. I wish there was a better fight scene for this quest. It's too fast. It'd be nice if you go in there and the guy force greets you and he's like, what are you doing in here? That kind of thing. Instead of just kill the player character quick, you know, that kind of thing. Because your only instinct is to murder. Be a murder hobo when you come in this place. You never get to know the character. You barely remember the guy's name. It's just the whole point of this part is just to get the note, to find out where the skooma is coming from. That's the whole point of this fight scene, is to find out where the drugs are coming from. So maybe these NPCs that died instantly have no point whatsoever in the game. In the whole scheme of things, as far as Skyrim goes. I'm sure they had an existence before I showed up. They could have had an existence after I showed up. But nope, they had to be murdered.
An amulet of Mara. You're looking for marriage, then?
Maybe a thief could sneak in there and steal the note without anyone ever noticing they were in the room? Is that doable? I'll have to go on YouTube and see if someone's played as a thief with a sneak of 100 and all the perks for sneak and just walked right on in there. But no, I'm sure they would have gotten detected. The fight would have broke out. Maybe they could use a spell to calm everyone and then they go about their business and unlock the door. No, you have to get the key though. You would have to sneak in there, pickpocket the guy, take his key, go downstairs, open the door, get the note, leave the room without them seeing you. I don't know if that's possible. I don't have the patience to grind away with my character until I'm able to do that kind of thing. Weird. The rain stopped, the thunder stopped, lightning stopped. It's still 90 degrees outside. I was hoping it'd be nice and cool and have a nice long rain. No. 10 minutes of rain. That's all you get. That's all you get for the month. I live in a desert world. Lucky we don't have... What are those things called in Dune? Sandworms or something? Or what are those things called in Sand Kings? It's a good thing we don't have Sand Kings in my neighborhood. That would suck.
What can I do for you?
I can barely see your face. Okay, that's a little better.
Speak. I wish to hear everything my subjects have to say. It's nice to receive good news for a change. Did you recover anything else from the warehouse worth mentioning? Then there's no time to lose. It won't take long for Sarthas's associates to learn of his death. The source of the poison must be destroyed once and for all. Otherwise, another dealer will simply take his place. Do this task for me, and you'll be well on your way to a title in Riften. Good. Report back to me when your task is complete.
There's a... I should have said, perhaps some other time.
Summoned the Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. Such a thing has not happened for...
What would happen if I said to her, well, perhaps some other time. Perhaps. Like my character would ever say, perhaps.
Did we have an appointment?
I like how she gives me all this stuff. I'm friends with her somehow.
I can't remember.
I must have delivered a potion or something to her. And now she's my friend. I have mods that let you give stuff to NPCs and they become your friend. Just for that. Give a stranger, you know, some gold and they're your friend. So I guess we're going to this area. I can't fast travel there. Man, I'm gonna have to walk.